everyone. Today is the 25th August, and on the 23rd, the Holy Spirit of the Lord gave me something that I'm supposed to give to you. I do believe that firmly. What I'm about to tell you, please take into consideration seriously to prayer, asking the Lord for confirmation. I'm just going to share with you what happened 2 days ago on the 23rd, okay? First of all, I want to say thank you for joining me. It's been a while. I've been tied up very much. I'm on grandma duty. I get my grandbaby in between 6 and 10 hours a day. I'm sleep deprived. I also homeschool my babies and I run my household. If anything is done, it's me that does it. So I'm very, 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 very tied up and I'm really trying to adjust to the schedule. And try to squeeze in rest and sleep so that I can function, because I have the Holy Spirit on me, like, get those videos out, and I'm like, I know, and I think of you every day, every single day, and I pray for all of you. So let me go ahead and share with you what happened. And so here goes. 2 days ago, around 4 p.m. ish or so, I was taking off to go and run some errands, and all of a sudden a song came to my mind, was playing in my head, okay? And I am busy. I'm testing my children right now. I'm closing down my pool. You know, fall is coming. It's going to be cold weather. No need for a pool. I've been doing yard work. I've been doing everything. But it doesn't matter how busy you are. When the Holy Spirit of the Lord wants you to know something, He will find a way. And so, all of a sudden, the theme song for the Harlem Globetrotters started playing in my head. A lot of you don't know what I'm talking about. Some of you know. So here is a clip of that theme song from the Harlem Globetrotters.
Hey, man, who's that cat coming down the street?
I don't know, but it sounds to me like that whipping man with the bone.
Sure having himself a ball.
Okay, now, why does that even matter? Like, what? Well, I didn't catch on right away either. I'm a little bit slow, apparently. So, I thought that was odd, listening to that song in my head. And I didn't have the radio on, nothing. So, I have no idea where that came from, except for it has to be the Lord. Okay, now, why does it matter? Hold on. Later on in the evening, after feeding my granddaughter about 6 or 7 ounces of food, she's 3 weeks old. She's hungry. And she upchucks. She has acid reflux. So her stomach overcontracts and she upchucks all her food sometimes. My other two children had that as well. Out of my three children, two of them had it. So, having to bathe her and myself because she puked all over me and everything. While I'm dealing with that, you know, cleaning her up, changed, pull off the sheets off my bed, everything, heading to the shower. When I'm busy, it's like 10 p.m. I have to be up at like 4 or 5 in the morning, exhausted. Again, despite everything I'm going through and dealing with and how tired I am and distracted, that song from the Harlem Globetrotters starts going off in my head again. This is 10 p.m. I'm hopping into the shower, okay? I really want to go to bed. I was planning on going to bed, but then, you know, things happen. And that song's just going off in my head again, so I open up in prayer to the Lord, and I'm like, all of a sudden, bam, when I open up in prayer, it hits me. Hold a minute. Do you remember that Holy Spirit prophetic dream the Lord gave me back in July of 2018? About this virus, man-made, lab-altered virus that they would make, that Americans made, Luciferians, speaking perfect English, it was funded by Americans. I was shown this. They were in a lab. They were working on how to make a particular set of viruses be able to survive long enough so that it won't die out in the air. It'll be on surfaces for touch contacts to be spreadable and deadly to kill people. and that the Lord showed me, I was explained in this prophetic dream that they showed it being done on primarily, their goal was to get it to spread on the money. And I was shown $1 bills and $10 bills. Do you remember that? It's this video right here. I'll have a link to the bottom if you want to tough, you know, through it and listen to everything I have to say on there. The Holy Spirit revealed to me later on that it's because there's going to be the first wave of it, the first release of it. It'll kill people. But then the other wave, the other virus, and I specifically stated there's two different agents, bacterias or viruses, whatever it was they were working on. Watch this clip. You'll hear me say that specifically. All right. This was July 27th of 2018. I had this dream. Dream of an apocalypse. One of the four horsemen, I think it was a black horse, I just wrote down black horse, puts virus on the $1 bills and another type of virus on the $10 bills to infect and kill people. And I wrote down globetrotter viruses. So I do remember, I wrote that down because it's going to be a globetrotter. It's going to be either done to just the American money or done to various other monies simultaneously. The $1 bills and the $10 bills. The black horse puts virus on the $1 bills and another type of virus on the $10 bills to infect and kill people.
Okay.
The Holy Spirit revealed to me that the first release of this upon the public, terrorism, it's going to be likened to the $1 bill, but that the second one, the Lord showed me a $10 bill because it means something. It means that the second happenstance of this, the second happening of this, the second wave, you could say, is going to be 10 times worse, okay? In the Holy Spirit prophetic dream the Lord gave me back in 2018, the Holy Spirit, while showing me these things, literally spoke to me saying globetrotter virus. And when I heard, and the Holy Spirit said it on my right side, when I heard the Holy Spirit literally say that to me, I specifically remember thinking to myself, oh, the Harlem Globetrotters, okay? So I remembered that because from when I was a kid, you know, they had the Harlem Globetrotters, you know? Better get ready to lose when you hear that song coming and them people coming to play, you know? So, that was my personal mnemonic to make absolutely sure that I remember that in the Holy Spirit dream from the Lord. Now, out of nowhere, no matter how busy and stretched and frantic I am, the Lord is like playing the Harlem Globetrotters song in my head, not once, twice in one day. Now listen, hold up. Back in 2018 when the Lord gave me this Holy Spirit dream, okay? Never once did I even remember or think of that song, and the Harlem Globetrotter song, the theme song. Later in November of 2019, the 7th, the Holy Spirit got on my bones, like on fire in me, like, get to making the video and release it now. And it took time. I made the video. I was ready to release it December 3rd, but I was too afraid to do it. I'm talking in 2019. But the Holy Spirit, again, had replayed the whole prophetic dream in me again for me and explained to me why. It was to crash the economy and to release the mark of the beast. If you go and watch this video and listen to my words, it's a kind of a long video. I wasn't very good at getting to the point back then, okay? I'm still kind of struggling with that, obviously, but I'm getting a lot of information out to you. Watch this video here. You'll hear me tell you why, what the Holy Spirit was telling me, why they're releasing this, their purposes, what they're trying to achieve, shutting down the economy, economic collapse, and the ushering out of the mark of the beast, okay? You see, Lucifer is not God. He's not the Almighty, right? So he can't do things perfectly. He messes up. He can be stifled. So, but when God, Almighty Father, does something, nothing ever stops it. Nothing can stop what God Almighty does. Now you can pray and ask for a favor or for him to alter something, and he'll consider you because he's so loving and wonderful. He can change his plans. But Satan, I think personally, they wanted to actually achieve full economic collapse with the first strain. And it didn't happen. It almost did. And that they wanted to do the culling most fervently. Bless me, excuse me. And in case it didn't work out, they have plan B, the 10 times worse strain. So even though the Holy Spirit re-gave me the same Holy Spirit dream back again in November the 7th of 2019, I still didn't even start thinking or even remember the theme song to the Harlem Globetrotters. But now, out of nowhere, in the midst of my own personal life and dealings and strugglings and trying to handle a lot of stuff, the Holy Spirit reached out to me. And that song was played to me twice in one day in my head. And while in prayer, I realized maybe, now here's my conclusion here, you might have arrived at it yourself. I think the Lord is letting me know so that I can let you know that the second wave, the 10 times worse strain, is either in play now, maybe, or that it will be in play rather soon, maybe even this year, possibly. I don't know when, okay? I'm not saying that this 10-time worse strain is out right now. I'm not saying it's going to come out this month or this year. I'm saying it's possible. The Holy Spirit is not going to give me that song twice in one day for nothing. And I want you to know that. And I will say this. This could be just the Lord letting me know so that I can let you know that things are on time. Everything's on target. Everything, God's in control. He is the Most High. You know, Satan thinks he's running things. He is so arrogant that he is the king of narcissists. He thinks that he is so smart, so amazing, so superior, that he can actually wage war against God and win. Yeah, that's the epitome of absolute delusion. I mean, it's broken. He's broken. Satan is broken. And so he thinks he's running things. He thinks he's going to do this and that and the other. He'll do some things. But here's the deal. The Most High Almighty God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he's in charge. Every single thing that happens, either it be bad or good, it's only because he's allowed it, because ultimately it fits into his will, because his will, and he has the victory. We get to join in on that victory in Jesus. So no matter what happens, don't be in fear. We have everlasting life, those of us who remain in Jesus, truly, in Yeshua HaMashiach. So plan for everlasting life. Try to wrap your mind around that. I'm still trying to do that. We have forever. So stay in the Lord no matter what, and get yourself ready, because the Holy Spirit doesn't give these warnings and is not this bold for nothing. Okay? Because see, the Lord, he's gentle. He doesn't force his way. But the Holy Spirit of the Lord, I've been praying, hey, let me know. Give me heads up on what's coming next, what to look for, what to watch for, what's going on. And I pray for this. And so I've done given absolute consent to the Lord to intervene in my life and let me know, pull my hair, let me know if something, you know, what's up, what's coming. And so I know now, and now you know, just stay on the watch. Also, this morning, a Brother Caleb, the End Is Nigh channel, okay, I'll put a link in the description box of this video here and in the comments below. I caught his video this morning, and he mentioned briefly, he said something to the effect of how they are talking about another COVID outbreak and how they might do another lockdown and stuff like that. And I know from the 23rd, the Holy Spirit was like, playing the theme song to the Harlem Globetrotters in my head, you know. So, it seems like things are fitting. I don't watch the news, so I'm not, you know, not, I don't know about all that, okay. So, I get my news from fellow believers. But I get my news primarily from the Lord. He lets me know what's up. Jesus is my news. And so I'm telling you right now that it is highly likely that this second strain or this other lab-created version of some kind of bio-warfare stuff that they've been cooking up, the Luciferians, that Bill Gates himself mentioned saying, and I can't quote him verbatim, but I think the second... outbreak will get the attention it deserves. Laughing, him and his wife. So I think that that's coming soon, like not in 3 years, like soon. So it might very well be rolling out, if not already out, possibly, or maybe next year. So just be ready. Listen, be ready. People are going to rebel against taking safety measures like wearing masks and hand sanitizer and Lysoling your home and bleaching your floors and making sure to, you know, keep a distance from people and not to go unnecessarily to hospitals and doctor's offices because you could be exposed, you know. Take necessary precautions. Please don't rebel against safety measures. I know a lot of you are against wearing a face covering to protect your air a little bit. Some people say it's actually an act of worship to Lucifer to do that. I'm like, no, that's taking it way, way too far, in my opinion. I don't get that at all from the Holy Spirit of the Lord. Instead, with my nursing training, masks do prevent you from catching and spreading TB, or even breathing in MRSA. Because people catch it in their lungs, okay, and their bladders and stuff. It prevents people from spreading germs into people's bodies when they're in open surgery. It protects people. So it's two ways when you wear a mask. If you have COVID, you're not going to necessarily spread it as abundantly if you're wearing a mask and being considerate of others. And traditionally, you are wearing a mask if you were sick. So they put everyone wearing a mask so that everybody looks sick, and it makes everything look like where everybody's sick, and it makes the what they're saying on the news look so real, you know. But the thing is, that virus is real, though. It is real. And if you catch it, I personally advocate for having a natural immune system and supporting yourself with healthy eating and supplements and rest. And doing the best, and prayer, of course. Absolutely. It goes without saying. But I'm going to be wearing my mask when this second deadly, 10 times worse, comes out. I did a video not that long back ago talking about how there's a second strain that some fella, I think in Sri Lanka, if I'm remembering correctly, that it was 34 to 36% more deadly than the basic COVID, the first one that they released on us. And that would make it exactly 10 times worse. Exactly 10 times worse, which is prophetic, which I spoke by the power of the Lord Jesus Christ back in 2019, but it was given to me in 2018. I released that video right here, December 23rd of 2019. The very, very first outbreak was December 31st at 11:59 p.m., right before the strike of midnight, January 1st of 2020, okay? So, and then people started hearing about it like a few weeks later. Most people started hearing about it in February or so, and March, but mainly February. So I just released it just in time. So here's a picture of the date of when I released it. YouTube is showing the date that I released that video, showing December 23rd of 2019, a week before the very first outbreak. Okay? This is all prophetic from the Lord. Now, what do you take from this? Please take it, bring it to the Lord, and pray over it and ask for confirmation. Do you need to go get supplies? We were out of Lysol. We were out of any kind of alcohol, peroxide, anything to clean your home, sanitize yourselves, sanitize your mail, sanitize even food products and things you buy from the store. Hand sanitizers, things like that. Make sure you have extra toilet paper and food and water and things like that. We might not even be able to get out of our homes to go anywhere and get anything for a time. unfortunately. In one of the visions the Lord gave me back in 2017, we were locked up, hunkered down, boarded up in my home. We were afraid to go outside. I think personally that's because of the fallout from having been nuked, okay? Nobody would want to go outside, no doubt. But it could be because of disease being very, very, very bad. And we know a lot of people got, you know what I'm saying? And so a lot of people have severely compromised immune systems. So another release of a similar strain to the first wave would be enough to do away with a lot of people. But an even worse strain, 10 times worse, that I would be so, as I'd be bold in saying, and I'm going to be bold, I had another prophetic dream of bodies piling up bodies. And every able-bodied young person being drafted, so to speak, in a way to go and have to help bury them, dispense of the bodies and handle them. House to house, neighborhood to neighborhood. Horror show. And in that dream, I was really torn and in bits because, broken hearted, because my son would come home and he started looking like he didn't even want to live anymore because of all the children he had to bury and stuff. He was in so much pain. I started to become afraid for his life in my dream. Okay? So there's a lot of stuff that's coming. Not to be in fear. Ultimately, we have everlasting life in Jesus. Just like this world is real and He has prepared us a place. He's returning very soon. Be ready. Be walking in the Lord. Picking up your cross. Be prepared physically as well and mentally for what we're going to see. Some things are going to go down and very soon. And I hate to use that word too. Soon. By the way, that reminds me of Brother Johnny from Tribulation Now Radio. I hope y'all caught that. That was an awesome radio broadcast. It was awesome. Podcast. It was awesome. I need to do a video where I release information about what the Lord showed me regarding Trump. I had 4 Trump dreams back to back. I want to share that with you. Because he strikes weapons. He gives the order for a nuclear strike. I believe it's nuclear. I'm not sure. You might be able to know better what it is if you catch that video. All right, so I'll be back later, Lord willing. Sorry I've been so gone, you know. But I think of you every single day, all of you. And once I get things settled in and know my schedule, I can start making time to get things done. Because I think of you every day, all the time. Jesus be with you. I pray the blessings of the Lord and his favor and help that you be prepared first and foremost with your soul. Be ready. And to be prepared in every other kind of which way he deems it fit that you be prepared for you. You be ready. All right, bye for now. You've been watching A Witness for Yeshua Mashiach. See you soon.